we lose 400 meters because of the without the gauge. So what is that? 29.6. Our ascent rate is 6.92. It's much quicker than we expected.
My name is Matthew Smith. I'm from Cadiz, Kentucky, which is tree caddy right across the rivers, and my major is design engineering technology. So as a presidential fellow, we are required to do 5 hours of independent research throughout the semester. We get to really choose whatever we want to research, and for me, I decided to go back to a project that I worked on in high school, which was high atmospheric balloon and the payload technology involved with that.
He designed a payload. The payload is the compartment or the system to hold instrumentation, and in this case, he's got a data logger and some GoPro cameras. And so he designed that in SOLIDWORKS, and then he 3D printed the payload, so that container that holds all of those instruments has been designed and 3D printed here on campus. His research is extracurricular, so it's outside the classroom, and he's able to take some of the concepts that we learn in the classroom and apply that to his own research. So the CAD, computer-aided design software, utilization of that to actually design something tangible is really great. We do a lot of that in our design engineering technology program, but this is certainly an opportunity outside class to really put that into action.
In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Oh my goodness.
Quite a bit of air up there, and it's gone. It's gone. It's out of here. Oh! Today we had a very successful launch. The balloon went out without a hitch. We had all the helium we needed. There was no on-the-ground problems that we had to try to fix. And overall, I'm very thankful for that. So the next steps today is to monitor the GPS tracking, and we will lose connection to the balloon as the balloon reaches 30,000 feet. If you've ever flown on an airplane, you know your phone won't work, and the tracker we're using uses the same technology with cellular tracking. We don't know where the balloon's gonna land exactly, but with the tracking technology that we have today, we have a good idea of where it's gonna land, somewhere in Tennessee south of Adams, which is where the first landing site of the project that I worked on in high school. For phase two of my project, I wanna reach out to high schools across the United States. So I have plans on reaching out to schools all across the country. We were given the opportunity back as freshmen at Trigg County, so I wanna give back.
I would like to take this opportunity to thank Dr. Danny Claiborne, Director of the School of Engineering, Dr. Claire Fuller, Dean of the Jones College of Science, Engineering, Technology, Dr. Tim Todd, Dr. Bob Jackson, and Dr. Kevin Saul, everybody else that was involved in this launch that gave us permission. We're certainly thankful that we've got a chance to do this.